Hi, in this lesson, we are going to learn how to enable CSS modules in a storybook. Let's do it. So let's start for creating a config folder, and then inside there, let's create a CSS modules file. By the way, this is just a preference, but you don't really need to enable CSS modules in your projects. In my case, I really like to work with CSS modules with a lot of arrangement that will make our components more modular and more interoperable. So this is related to Webpack config. It's going to be a little bit tricky, but just follow me. So first, let's create a CSS modules closure that is going to return an async function. And this async function is going to receive the config, and this is going to be the previous config of Webpack, because this function, what it's going to do is basically extend the storybook Webpack config. And in fact, this is how you can extend any Webpack configuration from a storybook. In our case, it's going to be specifically for CSS modules. So in our previous Webpack config of a storybook, we are going to search for the modules, the rules, and we are going to find the rules that are related to CSS. So the rules in this case, they have the prefix of CSS. In that way, I'm just going to test this, and this is just JavaScript code related to a regex. So in this case, I'm going to find whatever it finished with CSS. So I just write in my regex here, and what I'm going to do when they find that rule, I'm going to exclude it from my other rule that is going to be whatever thing finish with that module, that CSS. So in that way, I'm making sure that my new CSS rules only applies for whatever finish in that module, that CSS, but the previous rule is going to apply for everything what it was there except for that module, that CSS. So now I need to apply the new rules. So then I go to modules, rules, and I push a new rule. What is that? Because if you think about regex, and if the rules that are there apply to everything that finished in that CSS, it means that it also will affect my that module, that CSS. But that's why I need to exclude it. So the new rule is just a common rule of Webpack, and in this case it has a test object. Basically the test object, what it does, and by the way, this is Webpack code related, so if you want to know more about Webpack or you want to know more about regex, I invite you of course to do your own research, because as I said before, we are not covering the bases here. We are creating the component modern library with a storybook. What is important to understand is that we are able to extend the Webpack configuration. So in this case, we are going to use the style loader, and that loader should be already there. And if not, we can just make sure and install it in case of necessary. And then after the style loader, and again, this is related to Webpack, basically you need to first load the styles, and then you need a CSS loader to understand those styles. For the style loader, you usually have this option called modules true, and we just enable that. And finally, we return the config. So what we are doing here is basically mutating the config. I'm missing something here. Yes, this rule here, it should be called rule, not rules. Because yeah, we are iterating all the rules. We are finding the first rule that match that CSS, and then make sure exclude my new rule that we are going to apply. And we just create this new rule. Here I also missing this special backslash because a dot in regex needs to be escaped. So that should be it. So then we need to go to the main.js file because this is where all the configurations related to the storybook live. And here we need to import our rule that we just created. So we can import this CSS modules. It's going to be in config. And we need to go to that folder, CSS modules. And then in the module exports, there is an option called Webpack final. So we go to Webpack final. And what we are going to set is this is going to be CSS modules and the execution of that. Remember that CSS modules is a closure that returns the function that is going to use Webpack final and receive the config. Now what we can do is to update our component. So if we go to the stories, now we are not going to use card.css anymore. We are going to use card.module.css. We also need to update our component. And you are wondering, okay, so you mentioned at the beginning this is a preference, but what is the reason behind it? And the reason behind it is that as we were doing before, to import the card, this was very global. When you work with components, you really want everything to be encapsulated. So CSS modules is one of the ways that you can avoid class collision. So that will make sure that the styles that apply here are going to be unique for this component. In that case, this sentence change is going to be import styles from, and we need to update that module.css. And because now I'm importing the styles, it means that from this object, I need to import the classes. For that, what I can do is just write the styles.car. And this is a little bit tricky, but basically we want to access the classes from this object. So we need to wrap this again, because this is going to access the attribute dynamically. And that will do the trick. So I'm going to do this and just wrap. And this is the common way to access dynamically objects attributes. In theory, that should be. I am having an error here. I'm missing these brackets. Okay, so let's run a storybook. And hopefully the configuration will be low here. I'm having an error. So let's see what is happening. It says CSS models is not a function. So let's take a look. Maybe, oh, I totally forgot to export it. So let me just export default CSS modules. And let's try again. It says unexpected export. Oh, so as you notice, because this is Node.js configuration, we can use ES modules. So in this case, I'm just going to use module exports. And now I'm going to export directly CSS modules. So let's try one more time. Sometimes you get confused with all the syntax that you need to use. Here is crashing again, but it's okay. It says cannot read properties undefined rules. Let's take a look. If we go here, it says config modules rules. This is wrong. This is module. And this is module. As I say, sometimes it's quite confusing. Understand how is the structure of the webpack config, but that should be. But definitely not. So I just noticed that I'm missing this slash here, and hopefully this is going to be the last thing that I have to do to make this work. So now storybook is there. Let's take a look if everything went well. It should look exactly the same. So I see in here that everything is looking exactly the same, and a good way to review if that's correct, that we are using CSS modules. If you inspect this component here, let's just move it here. You can see now the classes we're because this is auto-generated. This is what CSS model does. Before, we didn't have that auto-generation. You can check it if you want. But now that's making sure that if for some reason I create another component with the similar class names like car or color primary, they're not going to collide. So you notice that it was quite messy to write the classes with the styles CSS modules object. We are going to create a function that will help us to make this better. So in our next lesson, we are going to see how we can create these style helpers in a storybook. See you in the next one.